Hello friends, here we have another project of electronics department from 123projects.in. In this project, we are making a prepaid energy meter along with recharge unit. Here, what you are seeing is a recharge unit. This is a 8051 microcontroller. It is from Atmel Corporation. Model number of this chip is 8089S52, which contains 32 I/O port, 8 kilobyte RAM, 8 kilobyte flash memory, and 256 KB of RAM. Here we have used 11.0592 MHz crystal, and these are 33 picofarad capacitor. They are resonant filter capacitor. Here are switches to recharge the stick or a smart card, which we made by E2P-ROM 24C08, a EPROM chip which is normally used in a TV and DVDs. All the switches are for different recharge amount. Here is for 5 rupees, 10 rupees, 15 rupees, 20 rupees, and 25 rupees. Here is a LED to indicate that recharge done. USB socket to attach the smart card or EPROM to this unit, a recharge unit. Here is a voltage regulator 7805, and we are powering this recharge unit from this 9 volt battery. It is sufficient to run this project. Here we have used a pull up resistor of 10 kilo ohm for the EPROM connections. The red LED is for power indicator LED. So when we insert the USB stick into this socket, let me do it for you. If we insert a EPROM into this socket and power it up, it will recharge the unit. Now I am going to recharge for 5 rupees. What I have to do, just press this switch and leave it. So the 5 rupees recharge done. Now this EPROM is recharged with 5 rupees amount for prepaid energy meter. We can change the amount with help of programming, and we can do it as per requirement. The same USB socket like here is available here at main prepaid unit. So use it, connects. Okay, now we will show main components of the main unit, the working unit. Here is a same 8051 microcontroller 8089S52, same value crystal 11.0592 MHz, and the resonant capacitors are in the below the IC. Okay, this is a step down transformer, potential transformer. Step down transformer is for 12 volt. It will convert 230 volt AC to 12 volt AC, and then it will give to a bridge rectifier. A 4-in-1007 diode is used for bridge rectification. Is a filter capacitor which will convert a pulsating DC available at output of the bridge rectifier to the pure DC, and then this supply 12 volt is fitted to two lines. One is to drive this relay, and another line will go to the input pin of this voltage regulator, which is 7805. First number pin is input pin. Output of this IC, regulator IC, will give us a 5 volt regulated supply, which will be fitted to this EPROM via this socket, LCD, microcontroller, and meter reading IC. We have used meter reading IC from analog devices. It is ADE7751. For PT, we have used a local PT transformer. It is 6 volt PT transformer, and here we have used 20 ampere CT. maximum range of the CT is 20 ampere. Here what we have used, these are output terminals and these are input terminals. So 230 is attached here along with this PT and the main transformer. This transformer will give a working supply, while this PT will give, PT and CT will give respectively a potential data and current data to this metering chip. It will convert this voltage and ampere data into a frequency, then this frequency data will send to the microcontroller. It will count the pulses and then it will process what we have listed in it, and then it will send a data to LCD which should be displayed and will control the relay via port P1.0. If we do not have a sufficient amount or we have removed the smart card, the stick from the socket, or there is any problem that smart card is corrupted or we have tried another smart card make a bug, then the authority code will not be available in that fake card, so the chip will not start the relay and then we do not get the power at output terminal. It is also called a hex switch, which we made in this. Due to some reasons I have to screw up some circuits, so I am not going to show it here in this video, but it is done in it. I'll show it you